You say, wait a minute, now we made sure that we didn't get in the banks, we didn't set in them. We just wanted to make sure that they got to be clean. Because they ain't nobody sit there. We just take them three branches there and don't sit there. And I guarantee you that Deacon bring a white towel down here and wipe over it, and you're going to see some dirt on it.
All right.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
That's right.
And let me tell you something that you might didn't know. And I know some of y'all do know. You can take the longest shower that you can. Put the best deodorant on. And you just start rubbing your hand. That's all you gotta do, just rub the top of your hand. And that's why you said, man, I thought I was real clean. You didn't hear me, did you? Because everything that we have, that in time, a change gonna come.
All right. Tell it, Pastor.
You didn't hear me, did you?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Take a pair of shoes and you just set it in your closet and just let it sit there. And you bought them new and you don't wear them. And when you finally put on, you wash them shoes. They don't wear like new shoes. They just look like new shoes.
That's right.
You didn't hear me, did you? Because time brings a change in our life. Yes, that's the reason that we must be ready at all time, because that we have to recognize that our future change. If you think your features don't change, then look in the mirror sometime. And then go back and get one of them pictures when you were 16. Now you still look pretty and beautiful and handsome and all that. But all you got to do, detail, just go back and get one of your pictures. I got a picture in this book back here, in the college book that I went to, and it don't even look like me. Now, if I didn't know that was me, I'll tell that ain't me. You didn't. I said that's not me. You said I'm me, because it don't even look close to where I look now. You can look at that and tell you the difference. Time bring by a change. That's what time it is in your life. Are you ready? If Jesus called your name. Now, he already let us know that in his word. Now, I'm talking about in his word. And we know that we're all going to celebrate about our Lord and our Christ this week. They have the citywide revival. And I guarantee you the pastor that's going to be preaching that revival day, the one in the daytime, in the one in the nighttime, in the closing of their message, they're going to talk about the cross.
Yes, sir.
They're going to talk about our Lord and our Savior, how he rose with all power in his hand. Now, they might walk it through till Friday night, but sooner or later, they're going to talk about the cross. They're going to talk about our Savior and what the importance was by him risen, that he rose on the third day with all power in his hand. Well, that's what Easter means. That's the reason that we celebrate Easter every year. Christmas time, we talk about his birth. And then on Easter, we talk about our Savior, that he rose with all power in his hand. Well, but that day and that hour knows no man. No, not the angels. And you know how close the angel is to God. But even the angels don't know the day that the Son of Man, will come by.
All right.
Well, the angels did not know the time that our Lord and our Savior will go to the cross.
Yes, that's right.
They did not know, but one thing they did know, as we know, and the old people know back in the day, they heard about on the third day he will rise with all power in his hand. Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
I stop by to tell you, my brother and my sister.
Yes.
Oh, Lord. Well, what time it is in your life?
All right.
Well, take ye heed, watch and pray.
Yes.
For ye know not when the time is.
Yes.
Can I get a witness here?
Right.
Well, we know a lot of things. Some of us know how to increase and make things.
Yes.
Create things and make it.
Yes, sir.
Well, then some of us know how to destroy things.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Have you seen people's that only thing they can do is destroy things. You build things up and they'll destroy it.
Yeah.
You know that happened in the church too.
Yeah.
I'm glad they ain't here like that. Well, you can build up a program,
yes,
and somebody will talk it down.
That's right.
Y'all gonna hear me.
Yes.
Well, you can have some good ideas.
Yeah.
Before you can get home, somebody on their cell phone now. And tell them, well, I ain't gonna be part of that.
Yeah.
I don't care what the pastor say.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna work on that event.
Yeah.
Well, and I tell you, child, just watch it. It ain't gonna get off the ground. Y'all heard that before. Well, you have some folks that they specialize in tearing things down.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
Well, and you have some people and specialize in building things up.
That's right.
Well, but I heard in the Bible, y'all,
yes.
If God is for you, who can be what?
That's right. Yes, sir.
Yeah. You don't have to worry about them tear downs. Lord, you got God on your side. Lord, you don't have to worry about those that backstabbing you.
All right.
Lord, you got God on your side.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, what time is it? And I'm talking this right here in the Bible now. I just see what the Bible say. Well, what time is?
Yes, sir.
Well, it's time to do right.
Amen.
What time is? It's time to live this Christianity.
Yes.
It's time to forget about those that trying to change your way.
Yes, sir.
Go on in Jesus' name.
Yes, sir.
Well, our problem is today we worry about what folks gonna say.
Right.
Well, my Lord and my Savior, He went all the way, and they talked about Him.
Yeah.
They called Him the deceiver.
Yeah.
They called Him all kind of names, Reverend Wright. Yeah, but He went on anyway.
All right.
Well, they called Him a blasphemer.
Yeah.
I'm coming. They called Him that. Every name you can name that is not even printed in here, they called Him that.
Yeah.
But Jesus went on anyway.
Yeah.
He healed on the Sabbath day.
Yeah,
they talked about that.
Yeah.
Well, He raised the dead. He allowed the blind to see.
Right.
He allowed the woman that had an issue of blood problem to became whole again. Lord, and He raised Lara from the dead. Lara was in the grave stinking.
Mm-hmm.
But God cleaned him up and let him come forth. The God that I serve, I heard Him say in the book of Revelation, He happened on me good, the beginning and the end. Yeah. Yeah, I heard one writer say, is that